One of the challenges we had in training and exercises was that how do we take and train as many people as we can in a realistic environment without exhausting city resources? The way we found to do this was to use the simulator. When we do exercises out in the field, it requires a lot of manpower and a tremendous impact on the public. But here with the simulator, we have six unique scenarios modeled in different places in New York City that we can use over and over again and just run them with lots of different people without impacting the public or using a ton of staff to put them on.
My name's Tim Denmark. I'm a captain with the MTA Police. Being able to visualize a scenario as it unfolds and watching your decisions, you know, being played out, having that level of detail in the simulation of the station allowed you to plan more effectively from the beginning. It was just a great experience for our agency. I don't think it's, the value isn't unique to transportation, but once you've done a simulation like this, a tabletop exercise just doesn't do it anymore.
We actually immerse you into a 3D virtual environment that the participants can actually move around and interact with each other. You know, a lot of tabletops, you're kind of fictionalizing the scene. Here we put you inside the scene, but it's a very safe and controlled environment. We can start and stop at different points, but players are actually in the environment.
My name's Mike Plant. I've been with the New York City Police Department for 35 years, recently retired. The simulator can be used on many different levels. First of all, it serves as a bridge between what happens in the street, real life, and also what happens in a classroom. It allows for participants to make on-the-spot, on-a-dime decisions, and also allows them to discuss those decisions and analyze those decisions after the fact and as the simulation moves from point to point. In my opinion, it's an excellent mode of teaching and training.
The simulator is not just for the police department and the fire department. It's designed where we can get a multiple different types of agencies involved working together in response.
My name is Dave Laguer. I'm the Bronx team chief of Team 7, the community emergency response team. The community emergency response team assists first responders during catastrophes and disasters, and we do a lot of emergency preparedness as well. We've been part of larger scale drills and preparedness activities, but the simulator has given us the ability to do it in a closed kind of reset environment where we can start over and try again, and I think all CERT teams should take advantage of it, and all agencies should take advantage of it. It's a great tool.
We can take city agency personnel or not-for-profits or even some of our private companies. We've had the private sector out here, and we actually can get them close to the feel of what a disaster scene is like that first responders encounter.
I'm Michael Koppel. I'm manager of operations for the Emergency Medical Service for New York Presbyterian Hospital. We decided that to get some more focused understanding about emergency management, we brought a bunch of our emergency managers from all our different campuses, whether Columbia, Allen, and our Cornell campus, down to OEM, so that way we were able to throw them in front of the simulator rather than sit there and read a piece of paper and read what the plans are during a tabletop exercise. They're able to actually experience the exercise and be able to see exactly what takes place and be able to bring that back.
We've taken and we can tailor each of the exercises or simulations to really be unique and try to hit each agency's core competencies if we had to. We can do multi-agency or we can take a single agency and just make everything around that one particular agency.
Brian Hastings, Project Specialist, Con Edison Emergency Management. I've had the opportunity to train over here and train on the simulator, and I can tell you what, I think it's an incredibly valuable tool. As we all know, in a real world environment, sometimes the decisions and the dynamics of a real job change quite quickly. So the simulator here can actually give us a true sense of the city environment, if you will, and it gives us an opportunity to kind of like see it from you know, the real streets, if you will, as close as we can, because sometimes it's really difficult, as we know, to shut down a couple blocks in the city just to conduct this, whereas we can come in here to the training and the simulator actually supports that very nicely.
Many city agencies get classroom training on SIMS. SIMS is the Citywide Incident Management System. It's the paradigm that the city uses to manage its emergencies in New York. With the simulator, we actually put them in an environment and allow them to practice that with multiple different types of incidents, which is sort of the most basic thing we want city agencies to do, is set objectives and set up some sort of incident command structure under SIMS.
I'm Rod Tierney from New York City Fire Department. I'm detailed over to OEM response. We are currently citywide interagency coordinators. The nice part about it is an incident commander, somebody who's usually an incident commander, can play up on the front line, where somebody that's usually on the front line can see it from the incident commander's viewpoint. And we can change the scenarios throughout. So in an afternoon, we might be able to get to four or five scenarios, whereas with a tabletop, we'd only get to one.
The simulator has six customizable, unique scenarios, all modeled after New York City. We can adapt those to and change them to be different types of weather if we wanted to, or night and day. We can also control the environment. The six scenarios are LaGuardia Airport plane crash, a seaport incident, a highway hazmat incident, fuel tank fire out at JFK, a terrorist mall incident with hostage situation, and finally we have a subway incident at the 68th Street Hunter College Station. These simulations really only take three or four staff to put on and can be incredibly effective. It's a safe environment, we can hit reset, and as people have talked about, we can change scenarios. We can do the first hour spent with a plane crash and then do something completely different, like a train derailment or a hazmat spill, giving each of the first responders or different agency folks a totally unique experience.